Well, good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, and Luke speaks to us. Jesus journeyed to a city near Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother. She was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her. He said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward, touched the coffin. At this, the bearers halted. He said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak. Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." The report about him spread all through the whole region of Judea and in the surrounding territories. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I love the line, "God has visited his people," because that happens every time you receive the Eucharist. It happens every time that the grace of a sacrament through the Holy Spirit fills us with the knowledge and the certainty that we are not alone, that we truly have God visiting us. And these people said that. God has visited his people. And that visitation, of course, is in the person of Jesus Christ. Whenever Sunday Mass is held anywhere, God is visiting his people in the presence of the Eucharist. In Jesus Christ, God visits his people. It's that simple. And we should be grateful. It's one of the most beautiful things that can happen to us, that we come down the aisle, we put out our hands, we receive the body and blood of our Lord, and we are renewed heart, mind, and soul in our faith experience. These people could not have known what Jesus was going to do. His entire desire there was for this poor widow who had just lost her only son. And so he goes up and touches, and the boy is raised. And it doesn't get more beautiful than that. The people, of course, are amazed and terrified, and God has visited his people. But for Jesus, it's simply a moment of healing. Beyond healing, raising the dead. Think about that, my friends. Jesus comes into our lives as well. Our prayer life should be rich and strong, because as God visits his people in Christ, we must welcome Christ into our lives. The visitation, well, that's the easy part. The welcoming into a heart that's clean, a heart that's ready, a heart that is imbued with love, that's where we have to do our part. The widow, Jesus saw her heart. He saw the pain. He saw everything that she was thinking and feeling, and he responded to it. We are no different. The Lord sees our pain, sees our challenges, sees it all, and responds to it. But we must be welcoming. We must be prayer-filled. We must come to understand the love of God that is in the persona of Christ himself. Take care, my friends, and I will see you tomorrow.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, this saying is trustworthy. Whoever aspires to the office of bishop desires a noble task. Therefore, a bishop must be irreproachable, married only once, temperate, self-controlled, decent, hospitable, able to teach, not a drunkard, not aggressive, but gentle. Not contentious, not a lover of money. He must manage his own household well, keeping his children under control with perfect dignity. For if a man does not know how to manage his own household, how can he take care of the church of God? He should not be a recent convert, so that he may not be conceited and thus incur the devil's punishment. He must also have a good reputation among outsiders, so that he may not fall into disgrace, the devil's trap. Similarly, Deacons must be dignified, not deceitful, not addicted to drink, not greedy for sordid gain, holding fast to the mystery of the faith with a clear conscience. Moreover, they should be tested first. Then, if there is something against them, let them serve as deacons. Women, similarly, should be dignified, not slanderers, but temperate and faithful in everything. Deacons may be married only once and must manage their children and their households well. Thus, those who serve well as deacons gain good standing and much confidence in their faith in Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. I will walk with blameless heart. O mercy and judgment, I will sing to you. O Lord, I will sing praise. I will persevere in the way of integrity. When will you come to me? I will walk with blameless heart. I will walk with blameless heart within my house. I will not set before my eyes any base thing. I will walk with blameless heart. Whoever slanders his neighbors in secret, him will I destroy. The man of haughty eyes and puffed up heart, I will not endure. I will walk with my blameless heart. My eyes are upon the faithful of the land, that they may dwell with me. He who walks in the way of integrity shall be in my service. I will walk with blameless heart.
Son and the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. And good morning again. And those of you who are watching out there, who are many, we welcome you into our parish this day, this morning. We have a lot going on this morning. It's been a very busy weekend with two weddings and two baptisms and scouts and catechist blessings and coffee and donuts and you name it, we got it. With that in mind, we place ourselves in the presence of Almighty God. Lord God, the readings of the past week remind us of what we owe to one another as family, friends, brothers, and sisters. May we truly learn to love one another more deeply. Lord, have mercy. May we settle the differences between us and live at peace with one another. Christ, have mercy. May each day be an opportunity for grace and peace in a wider world. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator, Ruler of all things, that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustice. Then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. is come.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Peter approached Jesus, asking him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 70 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven is likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with all his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought in who owed him a very, very large sum of money. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, be patient with me. Please, I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of the servant let him go and forgave the loan. When the servant had left, he found a fellow servant who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him, began to choke him, saying, pay me back what you owe me. Falling to his knees, the fellow servant begged him, be patient with me and I will pay you back. But he refused. He had his fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now when the fellow servants saw what happened, they were disturbed. They went back to their master and they reported the entire affair. His master summoned him and said, you wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, the master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother or sister from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord. These readings have a lot in common with readings last Sunday, and I regaled you with the story of my dad and his sister. And it's strange because it happened again yesterday. I had a wedding I performed here in church and kind of did a renewal wedding. Today we do the real wedding and then we do the fake wedding. We do the one in church that's got the whole thing, and then I go to the reception hall and I do a kind of renewal that looks very much like a wedding to the crowd that's there. It works. And it was one of the joyous things I'm doing now is I'm performing weddings for children of students who I taught and married 20 or 30, 40 years ago. And we had dinner together, and I looked at this very dear friend of mine, and there with his wife, they were high school sweethearts. I remember them when they were 14. Now they are significantly older than 14. And after we sat a while, and we each had a glass of wine, I looked at him, and I said, so how many of your three siblings will we have the pleasure of seeing? Because I know the history. He said, well, one. I said, are we still with the other two, kind of in a contentious state of mind? He said, you wouldn't believe how bad it is. And isn't that sad? So it's not last week what I was saying, even though it was a funny story, it's so very real. And the readings today, they just punch right back at it. But the one that's really important is St. Paul's letter to the Romans, because that's the core of who we are as people. If we live, for the Lord. If we die, we die for the Lord. We are the Lord's, and that's who we belong to. Do we act that way? Not every single day. We belong to Christ. We are the Lord's. And that means that wherever we are and whatever we do, there has to be that kind of internal knowledge that we owe something to the Lord in our behavior, in how we treat one another, in the way we live our life. And Jesus gets into it in terms of forgiveness, and he sets the standard and the bar very high. How often must I forgive? Seven times? No, 77 times. Now, that is not always possible, but it sets an ideal threshold. And as I always say when I come upon this reading, what it really says is, do you have a forgiving heart or do you have a vengeful heart? What kind of heart do you have? What shape is it in? Are you someone who finds it relatively easy to say, I'm sorry, I forgive, let's fix this? Anger has no place in our lives. Are you that kind of person? I hope you are, because as I said last week and this week, anger and vengefulness and hatred and all of that, it saps the soul. It dims the heart, and it makes you sick, even physically as you get older. It's of no use whatsoever. And what do we get out of the book of Sirach today? And Sirach is wisdom literature. People were trying to figure the world out a couple thousand, 3,000 or 4,000 years ago. And what is the first line? Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. Now, he's not saying that because you do these things, you're a sinner, which you kind of are. Even if you don't do them, but you kind of focus on, that's who you have, that's your persona. Well, that's a sinful state of mind. It's a sinful state of mind. Wrath and anger are sinful, are hateful things, even when they are not expressed, but that's the way you feel. It is sinful. Remember what I said many, many Sundays ago? When you're in a restaurant and you see a whole lot of food being thrown away, haven't you at least once in your life looked at your dinner mate and said, boy, that's a sin? Well, if you think that's a sin, what do you think about this? Maybe the person isn't exercising it, but if that's what your heart is, that's a sinful state of existence. If you're unforgiving, that's a sinful state of existence. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance. He remembers their sins in detail. God is watching. God is always watching. If you live and die for Christ, and Christ is in your heart, and you're made in the image and likeness of God, which applies to virtually every single religion on earth, by the way, then are you behaving that way all the time? When I walk around Wayne, I'm aware that I'm a public figure in town. So I am super careful about everything and anything I do. And there are too many people who are not. I make sure that whenever I'm in a parking lot, I go very slowly. I make sure that in front of every supermarket, unlike way too many people, I go at 5 miles an hour past the ShopRite, past the Whole Foods. And some people are like this. Honest to God, you could kill somebody. You see the look in their eyes. Their mind is elsewhere. My mind is on the fact that I work for God. Now, I realize I work for the firm, okay? So that does level a certain amount of responsibility. I mean, too many cops in town know me. I did the prayer, 9/11. I do the prayer on Memorial Day. Everybody sees me. But that shouldn't exempt any of you. Shouldn't exempt anybody from putting the welfare and the well-being of everybody else at least on par with your own. And that's exactly what these readings are all about today, because every single human being is a child of God. Every one of us has a heart filled with love and grace at birth. And by the way, we exercise that love and that grace throughout our lives. That is how we will be known, how we will be loved, and how we will be remembered. So the question is, how do you want to be known? How do you want to be loved? How do you want to be remembered? As somebody who held wrath and anger close, who was unforgiving, who always saw the dark side of things, or as someone who cherishes love and life and beauty and joy? And in here, so that the Jewish people were included, remember the Most High's covenant, the Abrahamic covenant, which binds us all together, Christian and Jew and Muslim as well, binds us all as children of God. We are so imperfect in our exercise of that, but nonetheless, it's right here. Remember the covenant, because that is what you are part of and you always will be. Such a beautiful letter of Paul. None of us lives for oneself. No one dies for oneself. The selflessness that is so much the key to how we should be living our lives. And then Jesus with this, you know, wonderful, wonderful gospel here. my heavenly Father will remember you, and you better have a forgiving heart. So, you know, there isn't a whole lot to extrapolate on here because it's very, very, very evident. And there's a gravitas to it because slavery was legal in those days. And so what does he say? At the very, very end, he says, he handed him over to the torturers and sold his entire family into slavery. Well, thank God we live in a different time and place. It's pretty severe, significant stuff, if you ask me. So Christ wanted to make a point, and he certainly makes that point. You must forgive your brother and your sister from your heart. And again, that's why the human heart is such a precious place. Is it filled with love? Is it filled with grace? When I now preach it, I had a huge baptism here yesterday for a parish family. It was really absolutely adorable. Remember the young kid named Jace who had the heart surgery, the Bosco grandchild? We prayed for Jace over and over again. Well, Jace is now walking all over. And when he comes in this church, he runs all over the place now. So great to see. He's in good condition. You know that little kid ran in. You know what he did? He such good Catholicism embedded. He ran right for the pew that he sits in on Sunday. And he got in the pew and he sat there. And it was the cutest thing you ever saw. But as I said at the baptism yesterday, and as I always say at marriages and everything else, it's that gift of love that we're born with in our heart, and I emphasize that. I said it before, how you exercise it is how you will be judged, how you will be known, and how you will be loved. And if you use it well, you'll be the hit of the party your whole life. You'll be the person they always want to have around. You'll be the best spouse, the best wife, the best husband, the best brother, and the best sister, because everything you do in life will be based upon the love that you have in your heart. Acts of love all day, constantly, even in the parking lot of the Whole Foods. An act of love. I'm going to watch out for my brothers and sisters, and I'm going to behave the way that I should.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our response will be, hear us.
That the members of this assembly mirror God's mercy in the way they care for one another, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
That the church serve as a beacon of reconciliation, leading others in ways of harmony and peace, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For those who generously share their time, talent, and treasure, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For the homebound, for those in rehabilitation, and for those in hospice care, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For those who are in need of our prayers and all those who have asked us to pray for them and for all whose names appear on the sick list in our parish bulletin, may God fill their lives with healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For all who have died to rise with Christ in eternal light, especially for Nan DeMuri, Mary Lou Carlin, John Glutz, Liam Paconis, and Frank and Lucille Marshall, for whom this Mass is offered, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us. For our brothers and sisters in Maui still recovering, for those who have lost loved ones, for the souls in Morocco, and so many who have died, and tragically for the more than 10,000 plus who may have lost their lives in Libya, for the repose of their souls, for healing, for the survivors, for first responders, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, and blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Our Lady of Consolation,
pray for us.
And now, my friends, as we have shared the Word of God together, I invite you to spend time with me in front of the Blessed Sacrament as we share our spiritual prayer of communion. Friends, we now invite you to spend some time in adoration before the Blessed Sacrament in the tabernacle. We usually follow up my reflections and my gospel reflections with this time. And so often I will say to you, pray and reflect on a psalm or on some of the words of the gospel, something Jesus says or a parable. This is a great time to do that. And so join me now as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And my friends, as you spend time before the Lord, may he bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Enjoy these moments of private prayer and reflection.
St. Jude is the patron saint of hopeless causes and desperate situations. Catholics have relied on his intercession in times of extreme need for centuries. This apostle and martyr has helped countless souls through his epistle in the New Testament and his intercessions on behalf of those who seek his aid in times of trial. Pray this St. Jude Novena for your intentions, asking St. Jude to intercede to God the Father, his Son Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit on your behalf. We like to say that he is the patron saint of impossible causes, because even though something may seem hopeless, with God there is always hope.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Most holy Saint Jude, apostle, martyr, and friend of Jesus, today I ask that you pray for me and my intentions. You are the patron of the impossible. Pray for me and my intentions. O St. Jude, pray that God's grace and mercy will cover my intentions. Pray for the impossible if it is God's will. Pray that I may have the grace to accept God's holy will, even if it is painful and difficult for me. St. Jude, you loved our Lord. Help me to love him more. O St. Jude, pray for me that I may grow in faith, hope, and love, and in the grace of Jesus Christ. Pray for these intentions, but most of all, pray that I may join you in heaven with God for all eternity. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The first sorrowful mystery, the agony in the garden. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The second sorrowful mystery, the scourging at the pillar. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The third sorrowful mystery, the crowning of thorns. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The fourth sorrowful mystery, the carrying of the cross. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The fifth sorrowful mystery, the crucifixion and death of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, our hope. To thee do we pray, poor vanished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us, and after this, at our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, the Holy Mother of God, that we may be worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, while meditating upon the mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And now, my friends, as we have shared the Word of God together, I invite you to spend time with me in front of the Blessed Sacrament as we share our spiritual prayer of communion. Friends, we now invite you to spend some time in adoration before the Blessed Sacrament in the tabernacle. We usually follow up my reflections and my gospel reflections with this time. And so often I will say to you, pray and reflect on a psalm or on some of the words of the gospel, something Jesus says or a parable. This is a great time to do that. And so join me now as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And my friends, as you spend time before the Lord, may he bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Enjoy these moments of private prayer and reflection.